Welcome to Drawfee, where we take dumb ideas
and make even dumber drawings.
I'm Nathan.
I'm Jacob.
And I'm Julia.
And Karina's not here today, so you know what that means.
Bone game.
Bone,
bone game.
Bone game.
Bone game.
We're finally back to everyone's favorite game, the bone game.
We all have them.
We all have them. We all need them.
What's the last one?
Just like us.
Just like us.
The bones are just like us.
Bones. Yes.
In the game.
You may know them for being inside your body, but did you know other people have bones?
Yo, she's dropping facts.
You ever think about other people having bones?
Do you ever stop and think, wow, every single person I see is a skeleton walking around inside them.
You know who's definitely thought about other people having bones?
Karina?
Yes.
That's true.
But also the people who suggested this prompt for the reverse bone game, where we take an existing cartoon character and draw what their messed up little skeleton would look like. We got the suggestion from multiple people. I got two here. One of them is Darth Kayla, and the other one is Bear.
Bear.
They both suggested this. We're going to do it. We got some cartoon characters queued up, and we are to generate their skeletons before your very eyes, starting with Nathan.
I want to draw some bones.
We got to think deep. We got to think deeper than skin deep. We got to think bone deep.
Yes.
Think about them bones, Nathan.
Yes, Julia.
Your character is Paps from regular show.
Paps?
Pops.
Paps?
Pops.
Who's Paps? I don't remember the character. Paps.
Pops. It's Paps.
I don't have a Paps filter on my microphone.
It's Paps.
There he is.
Oh, he's so good.
He's a circle.
Every time I see him, it makes me want to do his voice, which is like, oh,
my bones. You're drawing my bones.
That's what he would say, probably.
I got to rough in sort of the location of the eyes.
Yeah, that's like the roadmap of the skull.
Yeah.
Is the eye holes.
We've got eyes, which touch.
So it's got to be one hole.
Nose.
Imagine if your eyes touched all the time. Imagine looking around.
And your eyes are like going, rubbing on each other.
Oh, but then if you get an eyelash in one eye, you can kind of like get the eyelash out by rubbing your eyes together, like back and forth real fast.
That's a good point.
But then you just put it on the other eye, I guess.
And maybe we could be like crickets and rub our eyes together to make a beautiful song.
Oh, beautiful. Do you think Pops makes a beautiful song when his eyes rub?
I think so. I'd
just
like
real
to think
quietly
so.
To himself.
I would hope so.
That's beautiful. Pops is beautiful, actually.
Pops is beautiful, no matter what they say.
We chose beautiful characters for this challenge. This is all one hole.
So the eyes rub on the nose, too?
I think so.
They all rub.
I think they all do one.
And so then the rest of this is just skull.
It's skull. Well, here's the thing, because the jaw's up here, right?
Yeah, it
like,
has to be.
If you're thinking about like a human's skull.
Yeah.
Which I am.
So it's like this. Like this is where, so like this is all.
Wow.
Right?
Yeah.
I mean, it's got to house his big, beautiful brain and all those thoughts he's having.
But then I guess the question is...
Big chop, big
is
chin.
Does the jaw go... Like, is this all chin or is it like little and then this is all just sort of like...
Big chaw.
Muscle.
Nathan, you heard me. Big chaw.
Big chaw.
Big chaw.
Pop's big chaw.
Pop's big chaw.
Nathan, deliver us Pop's big chaw immediately.
Deliver us.
Oh, no.
He's a little squid. He's got squid head.
He's like a perfect mushroom shape.
He's a little mushroom in there.
Wow.
He does have teeth. In this one, he doesn't have top teeth, but sometimes he does have top teeth. Maybe they're retractable.
Here's a thought.
Okay.
When you look at people, uh-huh. do you ever think, you know, when you see them smile, that you're looking at bones? You're looking at their bones.
This seems similar to the same thought experiment we had earlier at the beginning of the episode.
You ever think about how when you see a tooth is a bone, uh-huh. but it's a removable bone? It's a bone you lose.
Well, not.
And then a bone you gain.
Not all. A bone saved bone is game. A bone earned.
This
That's
is
what
the
I
true
say.
Bone game.
Bone earned.
Don't say bone earned.
Don't say bone.
I think it. Maybe it's not all one hole. I like this better.
Oh, you coward.
Wow.
You got afraid of the implications. And you couldn't stand by your convictions.
I am a coward, and I'm afraid of what's happening here.
Nathan, you know what I like about this?
What?
I like that uh-huh. if you go to, like, grab his cheeks, you could uh-huh. just keep pushing your hands in.
Yeah, I think this is all flesh in
it's,
here.
It squishes in so far.
Right? Unless...
It could be more skull.
It could be more, like, maybe he's got, like, a rib cage... for his head.
Wow.
He probably has some organs in there since his body's so small.
Yeah, maybe he's got sort of like...
Oh, yeah. Head scaffolding.
He's got sort of like some bone scaffolding. God,
and so his head is like horrific. A tent.
It's like this a... is so gross.
This is awful.
This is what's in there. This we're just yeah. doing the science to find out.
I think this is a biblical angel.
You got your head ribs that connect your jaw to your skull. These look like tubes also, like they're like pumping fluid between.
Oh, maybe they're bone tubes. You don't know.
He's like Predator.
Yeah, I don't think they shouldn't connect, right? Like he's got to be able to move his jaw.
Yeah.
Well, it's going like behind the jaw and like connecting back there. Like there's a little spine that goes down the back.
Oh, kind of okay, like yeah. a bone ponytail.
A bony tail.
A bony tail.
A bony tail.
Here's the spine and these are sort of coming in, connecting back here behind.
Remember when the number one cartoon was Bony Tails?
Give me a second. Because it's not clicking with me yet. I'm thinking Dragon Tales.
Are you thinking, is it Dragon? Was that ever the number one cartoon?
It definitely was not. DuckTales?
DuckTales?
Is that
there's no,
what you're referencing?
No bony.
What else had tails in it that could be? Is Tails even in the real name that she's referencing? We have to find like, the bones of this joke.
Like, she didn't say My Little Bony.
No, she didn't say that.
You know, but that's what I meant. That's what I meant, and I just messed it up.
You meant My Little Bony?
Yeah.
So Bony Tails was never going to lead us anywhere.
Life is like a hurricane here in Bony Tails.
I can't believe you sent me. I thought for sure we were going to uncover the truth, and we did, but it was so disappointing.
I really went off in a direction.
This does look remarkably like Predator, though. You were right on that one.
Yeah.
I think maybe he's a predator.
Do you think that like if you put skin on a predator, it would look like pops?
That's bone game too. More skin to real characters.
Because predators have like a chitin, like an exoskeleton.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But what if we made that, if you made that exoskeleton an endoskeleton, would it look like pops? Scientists have been asking this question. And they can't figure out the answer. That's why they turn to us to perform our forbidden boneology.
Yeah.
Yeah. Just going to look up what a regular skeleton looks like.
Wow, you don't know?
For reference.
You have one inside of you. Just yeah. feel it.
Oh, you're right.
I know my body best.
Hold on. I'm feeling my skeleton.
Are you learning?
I'm learning. That was my learning sound.
It hurts to learn.
It hurts to learn.
The brain is a bone. That's a lot of people don't know this.
You wanna know some? You ever think about?
Mm-hmm.
You ever think about teeth?
You already asked this.
The teeth we have as adults,
yeah,
used to be inside of us all, and that's weird to think about. That we just did a really slow, arduous, like vampire fang process. That's not as cool. that can't retract.
An even crazier way to think about it.
Uh-huh.
They're like Wolverine claws of the mouth.
Yeah.
That you can never retract.
That's messed up.
That is messed up. Do you think Wolverine can retract his teeth?
Ooh.
Can he go like slurp and they all disappear and he's like rah, 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 rah.
Yeah.
Because he can retract his butt when he has bone claws and that, you know, and there's that one Wolverine that's got the bone claws.
Yeah.
He can retract the bone claws. That seems to indicate that he could like do it with all his bones, right? Why only the claws?
I don't know. It's a good question. I like to imagine that he only retracts his teeth when he like really desperately wants soup. He's like, I don't have any teeth today.
Yeah, they won't serve him soup unless he doesn't have teeth.
You know the soup rules.
Yes, yeah.
The soup is only for no teeth havers.
Soup and applesauce, please.
You can't have the soup because you'll be taking it away from people who need to have soup.
Right.
There's only so much soup.
He's like, but I need the soup because I don't have any teeth. And they're like, yeah, you do. You just got to bring them out. And he's like, you don't know me.
Do you remember in the X-Men movie where Wolverine did, he just put out one claw and it was the middle claw? Like he was
God, it was so rude.
Like he was given a middle finger.
He was being really rude.
Do you remember that? One.
Yeah.
Julia, do you remember that?
Yeah.
Wasn't that so rude?
It's so rude.
But that's what we love about him, isn't it?
Yeah. He's not like other superheroes. He's edgy.
He's not like other superheroes. He lives forever and continues just to be like a shitty old curmudgeon the whole time.
He keeps losing his memory as part of the problem.
He's so stupid. Just remember. Just write it down.
Just keep it in there.
Just do a memento. Tattoo it all over your body.
If you keep forgetting, just write that shit down, Wolverine. It's not hard. It's called a notebook.
Would his regeneration make it so that he can't ever get a tattoo because his skin would regenerate too fast?
Probably so. That's the real tragedy. So I like that he's got three sets of bones in each arm.
Yeah, because he's got to be able to do those wigglies.
Yeah. Normal rib cage.
Yeah, I think it's pretty normal from here.
That rib cage is going to have to go down a ways, though.
Unless he's got tall pelvis bone.
Could have a tall pelvis.
The rib cage doesn't go down all the way.
Mine does.
Jacob's all ribs.
Yeah, it goes all the way down, top to bottom.
The spine, and then, we got pelvis.
Get ready, y'all. It's time to look at Pops' pelvis.
There it is.
You've been waiting for this moment. Beautiful, people have been asking for this.
Beautiful little butterfly in here.
Like, show us Pops' pelvis. What are you scared of? What are you hiding in there? Release the pelvis.
Big networks won't allow artists to show big pelvis.
We're changing that.
We're brave enough.
We're an independently run channel, so we can show as many pelvises as we want.
And if you want to see more pelvises, support our Patreon.
Our Pelvion.
Our Patreon. Patreon.com/Drawfee.
You can get pelvis pics, monthly pelvis pics.
Monthly pelvis pics. And you know, to Elvis ensure picks. That a big company doesn't come in and say, stop drawing the pelvises. By supporting us, you give us the power to say no.
Yeah.
We can show the pelvis.
We can show the pelvis and you can't stop us, Warner Brothers. They're always trying to stop us.
Always. I keep getting pleading emails. Please stop with the pelvis content.
So the boots are part of him.
Yeah.
He's got kind of like a raptor foot situation.
Yeah. Oh, that would hurt.
Would it?
Yeah. All your weight is up on this bone wedge.
And I guess the hat's also a bone, right? Do we ever see him without the hat in the show?
I don't remember, so I'm going to say no.
So I'm just going to say maybe the hat is covering like I don't know, maybe this is just like a spike.
A spike. His attack spike.
Yeah. That's a, you know, vestigial now. He doesn't need it. But if he ever did.
He could like pretend to trip hat first into a foe. And they'd be like, oh, it's fine if he falls into me. It's just a hat. But then they look down and they're impaled by his spike. That's devious.
I think this is him. I think I did it.
I agree.
I agree, too. Take away the silhouette. Let's look at him in all his glory.
Beautiful.
There he is. I would know him anywhere.
I look at this and I say, yeah, that's Pops.
That's Pops from regular show. He's just a regular guy, isn't he?
He's just a regular old mayor fella.
Oh, God. The face ribs are really troubling.
They're really something.
But it's the only thing that makes sense.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So I think you chose correctly.
Thank you.
Great work, Nathan. Great work.
Jacob.
I will go next on this, the Drawfee show about the bones, the reverse bone game cartoon challenge episode. Nathan, why don't you tell me who I'm doing?
Yeah, Jacob, we're going back to the old cartoons for this one.
Okay, throwbacks.
You know, we've done sort of a humanoid, a vaguely humanoid shape, but I want an animal character. So could you, for me, please draw the bones of cow from Cow and Chicken?
Oh, boy.
The bones of cow. Okay.
Oh, boy.
Yeah, there.
Because cow's kind of a messed up blob of a character.
Sure is.
I mean, you just got to look up a cow skeleton and sort of map it onto this shape.
I don't think that's going to work.
No, probably not.
Because cow operates as though bones don't exist. And I have to force this beautiful free creature into a bone prison.
Yeah.
Okay, well, I'm going to do what you did, Nathan. And we're going to start with the eye holes. I think that's only right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's respectful.
Okay, so this eye is coming out, so that's not gonna...
Yeah.
This will be like this.
Yeah.
And then this will go around sort of that way. And then the nose holes, similarly, this will be down. This is gonna be a disaster.
Sure
I'm
is.
I'm so excited.
The nose holes will be down here like this. Okay.
Yeah.
Excellent.
Yeah, dude.
This makes sense for...
This is really good already. I'm glad I picked this one.
And then the sort of mouth jaw situation is really gonna, because the teeth will have to come, like, there'll have to be like a bit of bone here to hold the teeth.
Yeah, the teeth holder bone,
like that. And then this is like skin. That's lip.
That's yeah that's just lip.
That's floppy. Great. And then we're getting kind of a shoe shape.
The teeth are bones.
The teeth are bones. Hey, you ever? Hey,
don't you dare.
You ever think about teeth?
What about teeth, Julia?
Yeah,
what about teeth?
You ever think about teeth?
Uh-huh. Yeah. Yeah, what about them?
They're bones.
Right.
Exposed bone. But it doesn't got... You ever see the inside of a bone and it looks like the inside of a Crunch bar?
What?
You ever see the inside of a bone?
It's full of chocolate and rice puffs?
It's full of little air pockets. It's got that like malted chocolate ball interior.
Interesting.
But teeth? They're solid, baby.
Yeah, and they got little roots.
Yeah.
Go into your gums.
They're like trees in your face.
They're sort of like bone trees that grow out of your face soil.
Yeah.
I think I've gone far enough to do this now.
Bone trees that grow out your face soil. A good sentence.
I think we're doing really good sentences and really good drawings today on this episode of Drawfee.
I got to look again at the teeth. I couldn't figure out where they went from memory.
No, there's no way to know.
There's simply no way.
Yeah, you can finish up the whole sort of jaw shape, I think. I think so far you're doing great. This is all making sense to me.
Let's kind of get this situation. This is going to be like a dome shape like this, I guess.
Yeah.
For the two eye holes.
Yeah.
Which are touching,
but I think there's like a little ridge.
Okay.
Okay.
In between. And then the nostril
thin bone
hole.
Line.
The bone line.
Yeah. You got to look out for the bone line. That's how you tell if you're dealing with a cow or dealing with a Pops, just from looking at the bones.
Yeah, because sometimes researchers in hundreds of years are going to find the bones of these cartoon characters, and they're gonna want to be able to tell the difference between a cow and a Pops.
And they'll also find this video.
Right.
Buried with the bones. This is a bone.
Sure is.
Now we're coming to sort of a we're coming to sort of a territory here. We have a lot of choices to make.
Yeah. How do shoulders get so high is what I want to know.
Because the shoulders. Okay. Let's start with what we know.
Okay.
Let's start with what we know.
Yeah.
This is an elbow.
Sure is.
This is the arm bone that has two bones.
Correct.
Like this.
Like that.
For cows, who knows if that's true? But for humans, definitely true.
This is the arm bone that has one bone, and it must connect into a shoulder socket.
Yeah, it's a little ball joint.
So we're going to put the socket there.
Okay.
I think that makes sense.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think the chest is like mostly obscured by the head.
Okay. Yeah.
And then hands are like, they're like a lot of bones.
Yeah, there's too many bones.
Yeah, there's like
Does
a bunch
Does he have
here.
Hands or hooves?
It's kind of both.
It's sort of a hoof hand.
Yeah. So we're going to just, you know, give it.
Hoof hand. Ooh.
Give it both a little bit. And there's like wrist bones too, right?
Yeah.
There's yeah. Like some kind there's of wrist a few, bones. There's a few in there.
Why are bones so complicated?
Yeah. Hey, why'd we pick such a complicated challenge? When we get the bones, we get to just cover them up.
Big shapes.
But now we're drawing the bones.
That's true.
And that's harder. That's actually harder.
That's actually, yeah, it's harder. I noticed that too.
Kind of like the bones. Bones are harder.
And then the bottom ones are definitely like hooves.
Right.
So those are easier to do. Kind of like this.
Yeah.
Okay. So far, so good.
Yeah.
There's a pelvis in here.
Somewhere.
And I think it would be just like a pretty big one.
Yeah. I'm thinking...
Yeah, sort of a wide...
Yeah, and tall.
Yeah. A wide and tall pelvis.
So just big.
Yeah, it would have to be like something like this.
And yeah, that's right.
There's like the holes in it.
Yeah.
Like a pelvis has. I'm not looking at a pelvis right now, so I just know that it's got holes in it somewhere.
Sure does.
I'm gonna look up what a cow's pelvis looks like.
And we're just gonna crank the spine around this away. And I think that will be helpful to us.
Yeah.
Cause this kind of goes with the pose, right?
Yeah. Absolutely.
And then I guess, because this is like up here is the shoulder zone. So it's got to be like ribs. I guess we'd still see some ribs, but most of the ribs I think are obscured.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Maybe we just see like the bottom of a couple ribs. I guess these would be kind of cranked around like this.
Oh, nice three-dimensionality happening here. Yeah.
Yeah. We're really having to use the whole brain for this one.
That brain bone.
Brain bone. Woo!
Yeah.
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 Yeah, we'll crank those like that.
Uh-huh.
I'm saying the udder is not bones.
The udder is not bones.
Any way you look at it.
No bones in there.
The udder's not bones.
You don't need bones in there. Tail, though. You can get some bones.
I got to bring this around a little more. Let's 3D-ify this pelvis.
Oh, yeah.
Get it closer to the tail zone.
Very good.
And then we can... You know, the tail's just like a bunch of little bones.
Like a spine you could whip around.
Yeah. And then, of course, these things are bones, too.
Gotta be.
Of course.
Like little toes.
Like little toes.
just the little tuft of hair is bones. Okay. But the udder is not.
No, that's stupid.
Hair bones, udder not bones.
Udder's not bones. Why would the udder be bones?
That would be utterly stupid.
Ah!
Yeah.
Yes.
Julie is right, and she made you look like a fool just now.
There it is.
There it is.
I'm clapping for myself.
You should.
Thank you. You haven't even drawn yet. So.
I sure haven't. I've succeeded already.
Yeah.
You know, if these bones are to be believed,
uh-huh.
This arm here, the bone would have to go like like all the way down here in order to connect up to where I've indicated this.
Maybe he just detached that scapula to go all the way over.
Do we see the collarbone? Because the jaw, like you've drawn the sides of the jaw. Is there a hole back there or is it solid bone?
Oh, a jaw hole. I was thinking I was just going to do that.
Okay, that'll save you some time for sure.
But I could try. Do you think I should try?
It's up to you.
What are you feeling?
Because then I'd have to... There'd have to be like more ribs.
You still have the little arrow over the arm.
Well, that's where the arm is.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that's to let everyone know.
Because we'd have to indicate the spine then all the way down from the skull.
Right.
So that's fun. like this.
Uh-huh.
And it's got more ribs.
No sacrum.
What's a sacrum?
The middle bone.
Oh, the middle bone. Yeah, I don't know about that. We can't see it. It's like here.
Cows don't got sacrums. Yeah.
It's like here.
Yeah, you're right.
And then how do the collarbones connect? I do need to look at a skeleton in order to
know. It free floats.
You can say whatever words you want. It's not going to mean anything to me until I look at a picture of a skeleton.
Okay.
Seeing a skeleton and hearing about a skeleton are two completely different things.
Let me tell you about bones.
Tell us.
Man, ribs work way differently than I always think they do because I'm so used to cartoon ribs.
Well, this is a cartoon character, so maybe it has cartoon ribs.
Yeah, but I think I can make it a little more. Now that I'm looking at a skeleton,
yeah,
things are different. I'm different than I was moments ago.
Everything's changed.
I'm not the same man anymore. I've looked at a real skeleton now.
Me before I look at a skeleton versus me after I look at a skeleton.
Yeah, it's different.
It's fully a different experience.
Okay, yeah. I'm seeing it all now. I'm seeing it all in HD. Collarbone.
Yeah.
I'm seeing it in freaking HD 4K right now.
Collarbone inside the mouth is so good. I'm glad we went this route. More interesting than just the black fill, I think.
I think so too. This sort of goes back and connects around the spine. And you got these like backbones back there. And then the rib cage is coming off of that and down. Skeletons are freaking crazy.
Yeah, they're nuts. And they're inside us all the time, just waiting.
What are they doing? What do they want?
They want our flesh to go away so they can be free of this meat prison.
They just want to support you. That's what
they
want.
Or they want to support you.
I mean, you know, it's pretty varied. There's a lot of skeletons out there. They're pretty split on what they want. Some of them want to support. Some of them want to break free out of this meat prison.
I think they all want to break free out of the meat prison, but it's like some of them are more adamant about it than others.
Some of them are patient. They're like, yeah, we'll get there.
They're like, we'll have our time.
Someday this flesh will be gone.
You know who had adamant bones? Wolverine.
Nathan. You're so right. It all comes back, doesn't it?
Yeah. I know it's adamantium, guys, in the comments.
Just shut up. If you're typing, shut up.
I was just making sort of a little callback joke there. But I know it's not. It's adamantium, not adamant. But that's sort of where the fake name for the metal comes from. So I thought it was a good thing to say.
I agree, Nathan. It is a good thing to say.
I think it was a good thing to say.
I'm glad I said it.
I support you and your right to say good things.
This is jacked up.
Yeah. You could punch through this cow's mouth and hit its spine.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And ribs.
I think that ever happens, Mortal Kombat style. They punch him right in the mouth and it like cuts to an x-ray and it shows the spine breaking.
Through the back of the mouth.
Yeah.
I guess we have like some spine back there.
Yeah. You just can't get to it.
You just can't get to it. But with cow, you can get to it.
Because your skull go down.
Right.
A little bit. Well, I guess not behind your mouth.
This is something.
This is something.
I think you did great.
The pelvis is very wrong now that I look at it, but I don't intend to fix it.
Nah. No. It looks like one of those pillows.
Yeah.
Those like side sleeper pillows.
It's right for him.
Yeah.
Do you sleep on your side?
I thought Cow was a girl.
Oh, yeah.
Isn't Cow a girl? Well, all cows are girls.
Right. she's got udders.
It's so stupid. Cow would have to be a girl, I guess.
Yeah. You're right. It's right for Cow.
You see this coming at you in a dark alleyway.
What do you do?
What do you do? What can you do?
I want more skeletons like this in like Dark Souls.
I agree.
It's sort of the vibe that you get when the skeletons come at you. Like they all feel this excited to run at you.
They do,
when you see them.
When you're in like Tomb of the Giants and the skeleton on all fours really does have this energy.
Yeah.
It's like, I'm going to get you.
Here I come.
Here I come.
Putting a rib cage visible through the mouth of a cow is not what I was expecting to do today, but here we are.
I like it. I think it's good.
All right, I'm done.
Let me in, coach.
Okay, Julia's turn.
Yael.
What would you think about if you did a skeleton of SpongeBob?
The sponge. The notorious, the famous sponge.
Bob.
SpongeBob.
There he is.
Look at this fella.
Wow. Because the sponge, the animal that he's based on, doesn't have bones, really, right? It's not one of those bone havers. But SpongeBob has, like, a mouth and teeth.
The teeth are what give it away. That's how we know for certain that SpongeBob possesses bones.
So he has bones.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He for sure has bones.
Okay, he's another one whose eyes touch and make beautiful music.
We did all three eyes touch characters.
It just seems right. We already know how it works when eyes don't touch. But when eyes touch, we're not sure yet.
Every time eyes touch, I get the feeling.
Nice.
Thank you. Okay. So we got eyes. Here's the mouth area.
His two teeth that he has.
Okay. I think that's enough for now.
Yeah.
My God.
Yeah, that's enough for now.
That's enough for now.
That gets us there.
I think
that's
I'm done. Him. I think I'm done.
This looks like an Undertale character.
Na-na-na-na. Yeah.
Na-na-na-na.
You don't need a tongue. Tongue's not a bone.
No, I was thinking of the back of the... Like, tongue would sit here. This is, like, into the airway.
The airway.
But where are you going to put the rib cage if not through the hole of the mouth?
You know, you're asking some good questions, Jacob. Where do the ribs go if not behind the mouth? I think I'm going to let them... I think... Yeah. Yeah.
You didn't say anything with that sentence.
What?
She's going to let them.
You just said, I think, and a lot.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh.
Yeah.
This looks like he's looking at us. Is that what you've intended?
No.
You've given him eyes again, but made them worse.
Well, because the eye stems need a place to go into.
Oh, sure. The eye stems.
Right? Because if you look at the eye sockets in the human skull, they're like little domes that the eyes sit in, and then they got little holes for the eye stems to go into, right?
Right, of course.
I feel like, you know, we put the eye stem hole in shadow so as not to have to address the hole.
Well, I want to address the hole.
Yeah, you're addressing the hole, whereas we chose to insinuate the hole.
Yeah.
Don't address the hole.
Nathan, I'm brave.
You don't need to address the hole.
Julia's not afraid of the hole. Even though right now it looks like he's staring at us and his eyes are all fucked up.
Yeah.
It's like really scary looking.
Don't be afraid.
Be not afraid.
So those teeth aren't centered on his... the two teeth he shows is one middle tooth and then one side tooth. And that's what it's been this whole time.
If you think about it,
I mean, based on the evidence we're seeing...
I centered the nose with where the eyes meet.
Based on what the evidence shows, I think you're right.
Yeah, I am right. Thank you.
Oh, my God.
This is so cursed.
Yeah.
I'm sorry if the accuracies of what this bone skeleton would look like is upsetting to you.
Yeah, sorry this is making you uncomfortable. But
sorry
this is
the
just
truth
science.
Is making you uncomfortable.
This is just the truth. All we're doing is speaking truth.
Remember that if anything we say or do makes you uncomfortable, that's just because it's the truth. It's because what we said is the truth.
I'm sorry you can't handle the truth.
Yeah.
Julia, does he have a secret sharp tooth back there?
Oh, that's like the jaw hole.
There's like a little jaw hinge here.
It's a hinge. Yeah. It's just a hinge. Okay. It's just a hinge, everyone.
It's just a hinge. Yes. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I agree.
Yeah. I mean, accurate.
Julia's looking up a skeleton right now. I just want everyone to know. She was trying to hide it so that no one would know she's looking up a skeleton.
Shut up. Mm-hmm.
But I think there's no shame in it. And I think you should embrace the fact that we have to look at a skeleton.
Yeah.
Okay.
He's like a little bucktooth Elmo inside.
He does kind of have animatronic vibes.
Yeah.
That's true. Like two little flashlights would sit in here.
Yeah.
Glow.
Yeah.
Normal arms.
Yeah.
I like how cute those bones are.
Yeah.
They look like little chicken bones.
They got fit as, oh, it's a lot thinner.
Yeah, his arms are little twigs.
Okay.
Oh, those bones would be coming out of his arm.
Yeah, those bones don't work in there. They got to be real small. Even cuter. Make them even cuter chicken bones.
And then we got the hand bones.
Yeah, we got that little wrist bone. Then we got some bones that sit in there. And then we got... This is... Okay. It's like a lot of little Rice Krispies in here.
Yeah, the palm bones are a disaster.
Does he have... He has three fingers.
Yeah.
Julia, he has three fingers. Okay, then it starts to be... Fingy territory.
Of course, of course. I really sort of cheated mine because the hands were so small. If you zoomed in, that's what it would be.
Yeah, you would see all the detail that Nathan discreetly put in.
Yeah.
His masterwork of bone art.
Bone art.
Bone art petite. That's what Julia's doing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He's crossing his thumb over.
The thumb bone's connected to the palm bone.
Palm bone's connected to the... Wrist bone.
The wrist bone's connected to the arm bone. And so on and so forth.
It all comes down.
You know the rest.
You freaking know the rest.
Okay.
Don't make me waste my time. There are a lot of bones.
I'm going to make these real long. Because I want him to have room for absorbing the water. Which is why I made his skull so tiny. Because he's a sponge.
Yeah, but the water's always fully absorbed.
Do the bones absorb the water? Or you're saying you want to leave room?
Right, like outside. Yeah. All of this
is spongy flesh.
Yeah, that's room for water.
Okay.
That's room for water absorption.
Of course, of course.
Don't be stupid.
I am always stupid.
Don't.
It's too late.
My God.
So how many bones do you think you can name?
The hip bones connected to the...
No, like their real name.
I don't know, 10.
Do it. I'm counting.
Collarbone.
Is that what it's called?
The coccyx.
That's definitely one.
That's a good one.
Scapula.
Yeah, that's a bone.
The phalanges is a set of
phalanges.
Bones.
Phalanges. Yeah, 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 yeah. Love a phalange.
The tarsals. The metatarsals.
Metatarsals.
Tarsals and the metatarsals, yeah.
Patella.
Sure.
Shin bone?
Shin bone's not a name of a
tibia.
Bone.
Tibia?
Okay, yes.
Femur?
Yeah, yeah.
Skull?
Sure.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
You're at 9. You need
spine?
To name one more bone. I'm not sure about that one.
The vertebra?
Okay, there we go. I'll take that. 10 bones.
Good bone naming.
10 bone Julia over here.
Sacrum?
That's more bones than I could have named. I'm not going to lie to you.
Did you say sternum?
Sternum?
Didn't even say sternum.
Clavicle is the one that's the collarbone?
Yeah, clavicle. The carpals and the metacarpals.
How many toes we think SpongeBob's got?
I bet we could find out with a quick Google search.
I don't want that in my search.
SpongeBob toes.
I don't want to search this.
I bet, I have to assume that the toes match the fingies.
Yeah, that would make sense.
So like four toes.
Four toes.
Four toes. Four toes.
I think you only gave him three toes, though.
Shut up.
You're missing his thumb toe.
Is the eye socket bone called the orbital? Or is that just like the name of the region?
It's called the orbis. And the nose bone hole is called the norbis.
I drew a little nerd.
Actually.
I guess SpongeBob is a nerd.
Yeah, but the skeleton's a bigger nerd.
That's true. Yeah. No. There we go. That's how that would work.
He's got a little heart in there.
Yeah.
Aww.
That's so cute.
That's where his heart is.
That's where SpongeBob's heart is.
His heart's right in his pelvis. It's beautiful.
That's actually the porbis.
Oh, yes, of course. The orbis, the norbis, and the porbis.
Yeah, the three bones of the body.
The norbis is connected to the porbis. Porbis is connected to the orbis.
This song just
and that's
ends.
All the bones.
Didn't really need a song. It's pretty easy to remember. I like the skeleton guy. He's got charm.
I'd watch this show about Skeleton Bob No Pants.
Imagine getting a job as an animator and they're like, congratulations, you work on the All Bones show. Do you want to just draw skeletons in action a lot? Here you go.
No, I don't want to do that.
That would be a nightmare. All right. I'm going to draw the inside, I guess.
You're going to get some ribs in there?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Wow, I'm the only one who didn't draw ribs inside the mouth. Sad.
There was no way ribs were going to be in Pops' mouth.
I mean, I put ribs in his head.
What a sentence.
Yeah, that is true. But his chest ribs could not possibly be up there.
Could no, not possibly.
Possibly.
Oh!
Possibly.
Possibly.
This one also looks like a Dark Souls, but it looks like the little baby skeletons that run at you.
Yeah. I love those guys. It's like something like that.
That's him.
Is this our sponge?
Take away the gray. Let's look at him. Yes.
What is this reminding me of?
The really wide set legs are so funny when
really
looking at them.
He really looks like a little kid that's got big glasses.
Yeah.
Yeah.
This is great. I want to watch this guy's show.
What's the animated movie that came out in the early 2000s with the family and the dinos? It was like the future, but then there were dinosaurs.
Oh, Meet the Robinsons?
Yeah. Does this guy look like the Meet the Robinsons kid?
I know literally nothing about that.
Was that kid made of, was he bones? Did he have bones showing? I don't remember that part.
You know, I don't think so. Oh, it does kind of look like the Meet the Robinsons kid.
Oh, you know what? He looks kind of like a Minions.
Don't.
He could be a Minion.
Don't. Oh, no.
I bet you could put a Minion over this skeleton.
All right, hold on.
With little to no effort.
That's what he was reminding me of. Is a Minions just a smooth SpongeBob?
Oh, my God.
You're actually, like, not wrong. When you say that.
I gotta do this.
That's what it was reminding me of. Yeah.
Oh my God.
Oh no.
We're doing science.
We've literally uncovered something.
Oh my God. Dark truths revealed.
Are we gonna be able to post this episode? Or are we gonna get in trouble?
Well, we've said already that we're the ones who are gonna tell the truth.
Right.
And Warner Brothers can't stop us.
You know, if the last truth on this episode made you uncomfortable, boy oh boy, this one is going to make you even more uncomfortable.
Can we, in the thumbnail, have SpongeBob and like an arrow pointing to inside of him and have it say secrets revealed?
Yeah.
Or like something like that?
Yeah.
Because people are going to be like, oh, they're just joking, but we're not. There were secrets to be revealed.
Yeah, the secret is SpongeBob is Minions.
SpongeBob's skeleton is Minions. They're the same. They're from the same species.
Oh my God.
This is like the damn Da Vinci Code.
Wow.
Dan Brown's going to write a novel about this shit.
Yeah. Yeah. If you don't hear from us again, it's because we've gone into hiding because what we've uncovered was too powerful.
Dan Brown is looking for us.
Dan Brown's after us.
He's so pissed. He's got Tom Hanks and everything, and they're both pissed.
Yeah. We're on the run from Dan Brown and Tom Hanks. Wow. Forbidden knowledge.
Secrets
revealed.
Revealed.
Secrets revealed. Not clickbait. No,
this is not clickbait.
Wow.
I'm speechless. I'm speechless.
Wow.
Julia, you uncovered the secrets.
I have to go into hiding now. How do I contact the FBI and tell them I need to go into witness protection because I've discovered
too much truth?
You can't
tell them. They're going to be coming for you too. No one wants this information getting out.
The SpongeBob... Oh my God. The SpongeBob to Minion timeline, closer than you think.
Closer than you think. We have to end the episode now. They're backtracing our IP.
Yeah. Let's get out quick.
We got to go.
Thanks for watching, everyone. If you want to protect us from...
We're going to be on the run.
The government and Dan Brown and Tom Hanks.
We're going to need the money.
And Nick Cage probably is going to come after us too, because it's...
Oh, yeah.
He likes to do that sort of thing. You have to support us on Patreon. It's the only way to keep us safe. Click like and subscribe on the channel to be notified of our safety
as
we flee around the country.
Yeah.
And buy our merch to show your support of us during this dark time. To show that you care about the truth.
Yeah.
And you're not here for the lies.
One merch equal one truth.
Yeah. And you can also watch us on Twitch, too.
Yeah.
It's not really related to this. It's a different thing.
That's... it's still us.
It's still us, but it's not... We don't do truth on that one.
No, it's...
Only lies.
Only lies on Twitch.
Lies only.
Yeah. Thanks for watching, everybody. We are sorry.
We're sorry.
Sorry.
But we're not sorry for the truth.
Wow. I want to believe.